everybody, and welcome to the Monkey Jones Interview Show. Now, folks, I've got a really special treat for you today. I need to preface this with a little bit of a warning. This is not an orthodox episode of the Monkey Jones Interview Show. This was actually recorded last night during a live stream. But every so often, the stars align, and what was once a typical stream becomes pure magic, folks. So let me explain. This is going to be a bit long and perhaps a bit confusing, but if you trust me and you watch this video to completion, I think it will be well worth it. I think you will be a very satisfied customer. It started last night during a stream. I wanted to show everybody one of my all-time favorite YouTube videos by the Nostalgia Teen Critic reviewing an episode of Teen Titans Go. A very, very special video. I'm not going to spoil why right now. But after we watched it and I did my little commentary throughout it, the creator, Nostalgia Teen Critic himself, wanted to call into the stream to be interviewed. So an episode of the Monkey Jones Interview Show happened completely by accident, was not planned, but the interview, as it unfolded, became so electric and magical and juxtaposed with us watching his magnum opus video. Sometimes things happen on these streams that it would be criminal if they were not archived in some way, so I have decided to retroactively make this episode 5 of the Monkey Jones, I keep forgetting my own name. It has, depending on the website I upload it to, it has a different name. But this is now episode 5. Again, I don't want to spoil too much. You just have to trust me. I know this is going to be long. It's probably like 2 hours long. If you can't handle it, if you don't want to watch it, that's fine. I understand. If this gets 800 views, that's fine. Trust me, it's fine. But for those of you who stick around and you trust me and you want to see what's going on here, it's a magical journey that you're about to go through. So if you have the 2 hours to spare and an open mind, please pop some popcorn, sit back, and enjoy what's about to unfold. Here's a question. Oftentimes on these streams, we'll watch videos that I really like the Teenage Mario Brothers series. Baseball Sam does a series called Teenage Nostalgia Critic, where he does his version of the Nostalgia Critic. And he has one video that I love so much. It's really special. I'm wondering, should we watch it? You guys want to watch Baseball Sam's Teenage Nostalgia Critic review of an episode of Teen Titans Go that he really hates? Is that something that would be appropriate for us to do? It's a really, really special video. Okay, let's see if we can find it. Nostalgia Teen... If you guys can feel free to leave. It's not going to be for everybody. But this is a video that... It's a special journey, and if you sit all the way through it, I think you'll go on a journey of self-discovery. You'll learn some things about yourself. You'll learn some things about art, and you'll realize that the actual Nostalgia Critic is a talentless hack, and that this teenager living in his parents' house can take the essence of Nostalgia Critic and improve upon it in every single way. Teen Titans Go, fourth wall. I think that's the episode. Okay, here we go. I'm gonna pause it pretty often to commentate over it and all the things that I really appreciate about this video. And again, this is not gonna be for everybody. Viewer discretion is heavily advised here. This is the Nostalgia Teen Critic review of the Teen Titans Go episode, The Fourth Wall. Don't know how loud I should turn it up. Let me know if I need to fix the audio mixing. Let's begin. Now, just for starters, can anybody tell me the aesthetic choice that we are seeing on display right here. This absolute madman, this a baron of industry, has a whole new technique. Instead of using the editing software to put in the title clips, what this man does is that he will take his video camera and film his computer monitor of the titles and the footage of Teen Titans Go. He doesn't do it in the editing bay. He edits it and then films his monitor, folks. This is next level fucking shit. It gives it a sense of amateur filmmaking that is so precious to me. Something that you don't get from all these big name YouTubers with their fancy Vegas Sony editing software. This is Kino. This is what I want to see from a YouTuber. Somebody who is innovative. They make creative choices, sometimes out of necessity, but it makes it feel so special and homegrown. This is not a corporate product. You're not going to see any advertisements for fucking MeUndies or any of that dumb shit. This is a true auteur.
Hey guys, NTC here.
Very quiet.
And welcome to my review of...
Okay, it's very quiet. I don't know if you guys can hear that. I'm gonna turn it up all the way, and I'm gonna turn it up for myself as well. Okay.
Hey guys, NTC here, and welcome to my review of Teen Titans Go's The Fourth Wall with special guest star, Mickey.
Hello, my wonderful people.
Now, the thing was, I actually was going to review something from Samurai Jack, but then
this guy came in and pretty much said this to me.
Hey, if you don't review Teen Titans Go's The Fourth Wall, I'll do some horrible, horrible things to you.
So if anybody who has even seen a few episodes of The Nostalgia Critic, you get his shtick, you understand his tone and the way he performs. And the way that Baseball Sam here, the teen nostalgia critic, or nostalgia teen critic, the way that he can emulate it, it's like watching a Doug Walker performance, but it's not a grizzled, beaten down man who has been doing this for 15 years too long. He gives it a fresh energy of youth. And the way that he can so accurately emulate that sort of performance, where I can see the nostalgia critic emanating from him, without it making me sad, like when I see Doug Walker do it, because Doug Walker is a fucking sad, pathetic man. This is top shelf acting, first of all. He can become the character.
So he gave me a choice right there. Either I review Teen Titans Go's The Fourth Wall, or he'd kill me. It was a pretty tough decision.
But in the end, he agreed to do the review. So, let's take a look at...
Now, Baseball Sam Star is in a dual role in this video. And let me know, is the audio mixing good? When I talk, is it way louder or way quieter than the video? I can adjust if I need to. But he's in a dual role. He's playing the Nostalgia Teen Critic, but also this annoying character, Mickey, who I think he is also filming his computer monitor to get the footage of. So you really get the sense that this is a different character with a different tone. He's otherworldly. Sounds pretty good? Okay, good. It's balanced. Awesome. And Mickey is going to be the antagonist of this review of an episode of Teen Titans Go. And the journey we go on and the character arc and the character growth of Mickey and the Nostalgia Teen Critic is far more thought out and deep and meaningful than anything you'll ever see in the actual Nostalgia Critic.
Possibly the most despised episode in the entire show.
Really? This is the most despised? I thought episodes like The Cave or Return of Slave were probably more despised.
That may be true for some, but for me, I personally hate this episode more than the other past episodes. Not only is it incredibly unfunny, not only is it obnoxious, but once again, it's just the writers going like, oh, we just want to do whatever the heck we want, Alright, NTC, it's time. Tear this sucker apart.
Okay, well, let's go ahead and take a look at this piece of shit. Let's go ahead and get started.
Go ahead and get started. Let's go ahead and get started. Come on, the people didn't click on this video just so you could give a monologue. Just do it. Come on, get started.
This is The Fourth Wall.
So we start the episode off with the Titans having something called TV Night. But while they're surfing through the channels, they get an unexpected welcome from one of the villains named Control Freak.
And it turns out that he actually was one of the main villains of the Titans back in the original show. So, what sets him apart from the other villains? Well, it turns out he actually has a magic remote that can...
Dude, nobody cares. Just get back to the review. Nobody really needs to hear about Control Freak's backstory.
But Mickey, what if someone watching my video actually doesn't know who Control Freak is? Wouldn't you want to know his history?
Show him his history. Show him his history. Dude, just get on with it.
Yes, get on with it.
All right, fine. I'll get back to the review. All right, where were we?
So the Titans try to ignore him by changing the channels, but he still won't go away.
So the Titans give in and ask him what does he want.
What is the reasoning of this interruption?
Well, I heard it was TV night at the tower, and I have the perfect show for you to watch. Enjoy!
Wait, that's us.
No shit.
So Control Freak tells the Titans that he's made a show all about,
the original.
Titans themselves. And he also tells them that millions and millions of people are watching them right now.
The audience is watching you from just beyond the fourth wall. Look for yourself.
So yeah, the Titans are really trying to break the fourth wall. But hey, now that we got them in front of the camera, maybe I can finally say hello to them.
Hi, Teen Titans Go. How you doing? Good? Good. Hey, guess what? I got a present for you. Here you go!
Whoa!
People are watching us without our permission? Ew. Ooh. What a bunch of creeps.
Creeps!
The creeps!
You fools be creepy!
Hey! Stop antagonizing the audience!
Sorry, Control Freak, but Teen Titans Go already antagonized the audience seasons ago.
So Control Freak explains that he made this show so he could turn it into his little masterpiece.
It was supposed to bring the awards and the respect of the entertainment industry. Instead, everyone thinks it's garbage!
No shit.
So Control Freak goes over most of the biggest problems with the show, like...
Dookie jokes!
We don't just do dookie jokes.
Yeah, we do two jokes too, yo!
Okay, just because you can do a fart joke doesn't mean you should.
Your sense of humor is so lowbrow!
Yeah! Lowbrow!
Am I not supposed to be laughing at that?
You're a waste of thought.
Oh.
And then there's your acting. If you can call incessant screaming, acting!
But we are not the acting! This is how we are!
Ow, what the hell was that?
Yeah, come on, I don't need to have my ears bleed, Starfire. Just shut up!
And finally, the audience hates how you look!
Oh, I'm so sorry you didn't get any precious golden statues or industry accolades, but we don't care!
Yep, that's right. The writers and creators of Teen Titans Go have just pretty much stated that they don't care. Although this does bring up one important question. If you don't care, then why did you make this episode in the first place? And don't even bother trying to guess why. I think the answer is pretty fucking obvious.
Whoa!
So the Titans tell Control Freak that they don't care.
You would think a show called Nostalgia Teen Critic would be for the kids! Watch your mouth! Mom's gonna freak!
But Control Freak tells him that they should. Why?
Because if this show doesn't get better soon, I will reboot you all!
Hey, you know? Rebooting this piece of shit of a show is actually not a bad idea.
You're bluffing!
Oh, yeah? I've rebooted the Teen Titans once before!
Did he say what I think he just said?
Yes, it is exactly what you think it is, Mickey. Control Freak got rid of the original Teen Titans! Well... Now, I know exactly what I'm going to do after I finish this review. But, again, I will do this after the review is done.
Oh, good.
Alright, let's get back to it.
So Control Freak shows in their previous reincarnations, the original Teen Titans. And what a shock, they love it. In fact, they love it so much that they decide to watch every single episode from the show, all 5 seasons. And bizarrely enough, they actually react the exact same way every single Teen Titans fan reacted.
I've only seen the Teen Titans Go movie, but as much as he hates this episode, this is, I think it's really fucking funny. I shouldn't shit on his opinion because this is a postmodern art critique of his, and he clearly knows more about the subject than I do, but the writers of Teen Titans Go look like they're having a lot of fun. And I would like to imagine if I was handed the reins on this sort of project and said, just do whatever you want, I would probably do something very similar. All the clips that he's shitting on, I oftentimes find very funny.
Show was finally over.
That's how it ends?
And there is no sixth season to resolve the plots hanging from the cliff?
You ended that show? You monster.
You maniac! You blew it up! Damn you! God damn you all to hell!
So Control Freak tells him that if they don't give him his award soon, they'll get rebooted. So the Titans have no choice but to do what he says.
Titans, this is perhaps the most serious threat we have ever faced. Where's Beast Boy?
Yeah, where is Beast Boy? I mean, he was on the couch a moment ago and now he's gone, so where is he?
Doing his underpants dance in front of the fourth wall.
Wait, what?
Yo, creeps! You wanna be creepy? Creep on this! Creeping like a creeper, creeping like a creeper. Creeping like a creeper.
Okay, I think this is the first time I've ever actually been sexually assaulted. Except, not physically.
Really? This is what's considered comedy gold to the Teen Titans Go writers? Beast Boy just twerking his ass to the camera? That's it? That's the best it could come up with?
I mean, these writers probably went to college, right? Well, if that's the case, then why did they have to come up with something that maybe a five-year-old could come up with?
Good point.
Hey, NTC, calm down, buddy.
Dude, Mickey, I'm fine. I'm just getting a little agitated, that's all.
No, come on. You really need to calm down. Come on, work with me. Okay, now you tried.
Ugh, fine.
Better?
I guess. Okay, let's get back to the review.
So Robin insists to the group that if they don't start improving soon, their show's gonna get rebooted. So that means they have to completely change themselves.
If we're going to play Control Freak's demented game, it's time to lose the lowbrow humor, which means no more dookie jokes! We do smart people comedy from now on!
Okay, good. So the Titans are actually wanting to try and change themselves. Okay, perfect. Maybe we can actually get some good things out of this.
Now shut your butts and let's get highbrow!
Did you hear the news about the election?
You'll have to speak up. I'm listening to the current exit polls concerning the election.
This is not what I meant!
Seriously? Seriously? Look, it's just like the fart joke. Just because you can do it doesn't automatically mean it'll be funny just like that. I mean, it takes a lot more than just doing a stupid accent.
I mean, by God, imagine if Simon Pegg, one of the funniest British actors of all time, just used his accent to make you laugh instead of just telling you jokes. I mean, it wasn't an accent that made him funny. It was clever writing, good jokes, and good satire that made him funny. That's what made people love the Cornetto trilogy and some of his Star Trek films.
But here, the Titans are just saying some unfunny stuff in an English accent, and that's pretty much it. And that's not funny. I mean, come on. Anybody could do a distinct accent. Show him, Reznov.
Gladly, NTC. Hello, my good chaps. My name is Lesnar Makarov, and today I'm going to be reading you some random sentences right here on this piece of paper. This is a segment that I like to call
Sometimes.
Alright, let's get started. Let's get some classical music going here. Ah, the sweet sound.
He's filming on his laptop webcam.
Alright, let's get started with random sentence number one. Sometimes I like to eat nachos with bean dip while bathing in hippo mucus. Random sentence number two. Sometimes I like to watch old men swearing while eating jelly with carrots. Has any of you tried that? Nah, forget it. Random sentence number three. Sometimes I like to listen to Nickelback while shaving my pubes. And finally, here's the last one. Sometimes I clean myself off with monkey poo while watching dogs humping people. And there you go, folks. Those are my random sentences.
Hectorito, I think you've really captured the essence of what we're watching here. He's the perfect reincarnation of Nostalgia Critic, where Nostalgia Critic would waste everybody's time with horrible skits. But I think the difference here is that he has taken that format and he polished the turd that the Nostalgia Critic came up with, and now we get pure Kino like this. I think he's really perfected the Nostalgia Critic formula with the vibrance of youth injected into it. And you wouldn't get that from Nostalgia Critic. You just wouldn't.
It's like that. Hope you enjoyed the segment called Sometimes. Back to you, NTC. By the way, I've never done this. Like, seriously, these are just jokes.
Thanks, Reznov. Okay, maybe some of those sentences weren't that funny, but hey, at least he wasn't just trying to make you laugh by using his little accent. He was at least trying to make you laugh by telling you some jokes. And I think we can both agree that those sentences right there are much funnier than what Teen Titans Go has to offer.
Okay, I need a break.
I'm sorry, but after seeing Beast Boy twerk in front of the camera and seeing the rest of the Titans use their stupid British accents, I think it's the perfect time to have a water break. And yes, I can be sophisticated too.
Hey, NTC, can I ask you a question?
Okay, go ahead. Shoot.
How's your sex life?
What?
How's your sex life?
Okay, two things. One, only weirdos like Tommy Wiseau ask questions like that. And two, why do you want to know about that?
Because I want to know. Oh, wait a minute. Let me guess. You probably don't have a sex life, right?
No, I don't have a sex life.
Wow, you fucking pussy, come on. You know that getting laid is the best way to make yourself cool.
No, you can still be cool even if you haven't had sex yet.
Nah, the only way to actually be cool is to make sure that you've actually gotten laid. Besides, I've gotten laid tons of times.
Oh, really? How many times?
10 times. In fact, there was even one point I actually had sex with 5 women at one time.
Oh my god.
Oh, hey, and let me ask you another question. Is it true that you actually haven't kissed a girl in years?
Yes, it's true. I haven't kissed a girl in years.
Wow, your romantic life sucks. You really need to get a girlfriend, you loser. Okay, that's all I wanted to ask. Back to the review.
What the... okay, let's get back to the review.
Now, I said that this video really takes you on an emotional journey, and you might think, you know, that scene right there seemed as if it was just out of the blue, a non sequitur that we'll never see again, but no. You see, this video ultimately has a very powerful message that I think intentionally hits deep within Baseball Sam's heart and soul. As the story goes on and during the resolution, there is a speech given where I think the way we're supposed to interpret the events of the skits in this video is that Baseball Sam himself is bearing his soul about the insecurities he faces in life and perhaps some of the bullying he faces at school, and it becomes very real, and you realize this is no longer just the Nostalgia Teen Critic. This is Baseball Sam himself bearing his insecurities and his soul on screen to all of us. And I think that's what makes this video so special, is that he doesn't stay in character for the whole thing. We're not watching a character. What we just watched was Baseball Sam himself arguing with a character that he is playing, folks. It's the duality of man, the inner struggle we all face, the voices in all of our heads that beat us down continuously, day by day. We all face it, we've all experienced it, but so few of us have the balls to talk about these things publicly and to even insert them into our Teen Titans Go reviews. And if you thought that was perhaps uncomfortable or perhaps a little bit too much, just you wait. There's more of that to come, and it becomes deeper and deeper as the video goes on, and that's why I say this video is some next-level Kino. We see a young man not only reviewing a postmodern piece of art like the Fourth Wall episode of Teen Titans Go, but bearing the essence of his soul.
We then cut to a movie studio where Robin is trying to get the rest of his Titans to act a lot better. And he tries to do this by giving them a certain sentence and tells them to express it in a different way, like expressing the sentence in sadness or happiness and so forth. But Robin doesn't like their performances at all.
So Robin tries to show the rest of the Titans how to do a award-winning performance.
Mary took her ducks to the pond where they ate breadcrumbs.
Okay, that's not award-winning acting. That's more like Jim Carrey over-the-top acting.
And no, just because you can cry doesn't mean it's good acting.
I mean, look, here are a few examples of some award-winning acting.
And the chips are down. These civilized people, they'll eat each other.
I love this fucking video.
See, I'm not a monster. I'm just ahead of the
curve. We live in a society!
I am the president of the United States of America, clothed in immense power. You will procure me these votes.
I'm an old broken down piece of meat, and I'm alone, and I deserve to be all alone.
Now that is good acting, but this, the acting that Robin just pulled off, that's not good acting at all. I mean, come on, Robin, it's not that hard to be good at it.
Hey, you want to know something that isn't just as hard?
What? What's not just as hard?
Not my dick when I was using it to fuck your mother last night.
Baseball Sam, playing a character, just told Baseball Sam that he fucked his mother.
Are you serious?
Oh, come on, the opportunity was just right there. Well, come on, get back to the review.
Okay.
In the next scene, we see Robin bring up the next big step on improving a show, improving your animation quality.
You mean bringing dead people back to life? Metreon system!
No, that's reanimation, Raven.
Oh, sorry, guys.
Okay, how can Raven be this dumb? I mean, there's a difference between changing your animation quality and bringing people back from the dead. Actually, that's a big major difference, so why would you confuse the two? Raven, you're one of the smarter people in the group. You know better.
Animation is created by countless talented animators laboring day and night to create the illusion of life.
And those are not the words that describe the Teen Titans Go animators.
So Robin forces the animators to change their look. So instead of having cheap, bright, flashy-looking animation, they instead now have animation that looks like a retarded version of Adventure Time.
Now that is some whimsy.
Feels like a student film, yo!
Oh, yes. A true labor of the love.
The quality of movement, it's astounding.
Okay, now they got a new look. So, what are they going to do next in order to make their show a whole lot better?
Talk like Englishmen again. Because we didn't have enough. God!
Why, I would love nothing more in the world than a slice of 3.14159.
Oh, circular, you. Sava!
Now, if you would all excuse me, I need to toot. It's not funny! Ah, wonderful! I believe our brows are the highest they've ever been, and our performances are worthy of Shakespeare!
Okay, why is this funny? Why is this super funny? You've already done this before! It was
funny.
Not funny then, and it's not funny now! Why do you need to keep doing this, you idiots?
Hey, calm down, chill.
No, I am not going to chill. These guys deserve a freak out.
No, come on, please work with me again. Come on, deal with me.
But I don't...
Okay, you good?
Yeah, I'm good. Hey, let me do it on my own, okay? Okay, now I feel a whole lot better.
Yeah, sure.
Alright, let's get back to it.
So Control Freak is impressed that they were able to improve themselves this way. But it turns out that this was his evil game all along, to make the reboot themselves without Control Freak actually having to do anything.
You're so dumb. You are really dumb. For real.
So the Titans decide they need to turn themselves back to normal. So, how are they going to turn themselves back into their normal selves?
Titans, toot!
Oh no, 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 no!
All together?
We's back, yo!
Okay, that's it, that's it! That's it!
Hey, 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 what are you doing? You still got a review to do! Wait, why'd you take the baseball bat with you?
A few moments later.
Now, interesting detail. He has a crucifix up on the wall above his bedroom door! That's right! Further evidence that if Mom and Dad knew the dirty language and the inappropriate gestures he was doing at the camera, Mom would freak!
Okay, I'm gonna need you. What the fuck is this? This is what they consider comedy. This is what they consider hilarious. Seriously, it's just the Titans farting it. How is this funny? My God, this episode isn't just bad. It is just horrifically bad. I mean, my God.
Hey, 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 come on, NTC. You can finish the review. I know you can finish it.
I'm trying to, Mickey. I'm really trying, but it is just so fucking hard.
Hey, you want to know what else is hard?
What?
My dick when it was shoving your mouth pussy last night. Now come on, finish the review once and for all.
I swear to God, I'm gonna kill you. Okay, alright. Let's just finish this. So Robin gives Control Freak a big speech about what they believe in. And you know what? What Robin says right here is pretty much like what the writers are pretty much telling us. In fact, here, how about we change the scene? Instead of just Robin telling this to Control Freak, imagine Robin is actually the writers and Control Freak is the audience.
Reboot us if you want, Control Freak. But we are proud of who we are and what we represent. And we are not changing any of that based on your evil whims.
So yeah, the people behind Teen Titans Go have pretty much stated that they don't care what you think. They represent what they want to represent, and there is nothing that we can do about it to change it. Nothing at all. We are going to stay exactly the same, whether you like it or not. Okay, let's just finish this once and for all. So, despite being moved by this wonderful speech, Control Freak is still going to reboot them anyway. So, how are the Titans going to get themselves out of this one? Well, they come up with this idea. If they can literally break the fourth wall, then they won't be rebooted.
So they do this by literally breaking the camera. And after they do, the episode finally ends.
So that's the episode.
What are my thoughts? Just say your thoughts, dude. End the review.
This episode sucks.
This was a horrible episode. It was unfunny, it was lazy, it was stupid, and once again, it's just the writers trying to defend themselves even though they have nothing to defend. It is a horrible episode, and once again, it just shows that the writers have a very light skin. Fuck this episode. And you want to know what I would give this as a final score? A -8. Whoa. Fuck this episode. Now, this isn't as bad as Return of Slay or The True Meaning of Christmas, but it is definitely horrible. Probably in the top 3. Fuck this episode and fuck this show. Again.
Well, guys, that's pretty much it.
guys, that's pretty much it. Well, guys.
Okay, so as you can see, we still have about 14 minutes left, and he's done reviewing the episode. So I think this is when he really dives deep, and we see Baseball Sam bare his soul to us. And really, it's a form of therapy, I think, with his two characters talking to each other. I think he's working out some demons, and we get to watch this unfold, and it's really special, and it's pure Kino. So let's just jump into it.
That's pretty much it. Come on, just end your review, dude.
You know what? I'm actually going to go on a little bit longer.
Oh, really? Are you going to keep on saying how bad this episode is?
No, actually, I'm going to start talking about how bad you've been. What the hell is the matter with you? I mean, you've been a complete thorn in my backside throughout this entire review.
Backside.
Shut up. You've been a complete nuisance throughout this entire review. You've interrupted the review plenty of times. You've asked me sexual questions that have made me uncomfortable. You call me a loser and a fucking pussy. And you had the balls to make sex jokes about my mother. I mean, along with you, this review was very hard to get through.
Hey, you wanna know what else was hard to get through?
Now, it's such a genuine, authentic level of righteous indignation that he's making against his own character, saying the things that he himself wrote. And the level of passion and anger that I feel from his performance, I think, really, it shines through to it being... he's not just talking to this character, Mickey. I think there's somebody he goes to school with, or maybe a little voice inside his head, that this is actually intended for, and he's just working that out to make himself... perhaps feel better in some way, or just to work out his demons, like I said before, through this video. And that's why I enjoy it so much.
What?
Having sex with your mother all night long. Oh! Oh, 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 oh.
Are you fucking kidding me?
What?
You made another sex joke about my mother?
Yeah, come on, it's funny.
It wasn't funny the first time, it wasn't funny the second time, and it wasn't funny the third time. And I do not care if you think you were joking, it still wasn't funny, and yet you still kept on doing it!
Hey, calm down, come on, chill, buddy, chill.
No, I am not going to chill! You have been awful throughout this entire video. You are a fucking asshole! You tried to calm me down even though I didn't need to be calmed down. You asked me how's my sex life. You call me a fucking pussy and a loser. And you have interrupted my review several times. And you made the exact same mom sex joke 3 times without change. And again, I don't care if you say you were joking. If someone is annoyed by your jokes, you stop. But you didn't stop. You just kept on doing it over and over and over again. It wasn't funny the first time, and it wasn't funny this time. You are a motherfucking asshole. Plain and simple. You cannot stop making your jokes, and you are not funny at all. And you wanna know something? My mother is sensitive. And if she actually heard these sex jokes, she would probably have her feelings hurt. Hell, she would probably cry. And I don't wanna see my mother cry over these jokes. I love my mother a lot. I love my father, I love my brothers, and I love my dog Chance. I love them all. And if anybody made a fucking sex joke about any of them, and they kept on doing it over and over and over again, I would do whatever I can to make them stop. I don't want my feelings being hurt, and I don't want their feelings being hurt by these stupid jokes. Oh, and you wanna know something else? All the stuff that you did in this video is something I've had to deal with back in school.
Oh, come on, really? When did they do this? Elementary school? 5th grade?
No. In high school. Including right now.
Really?
Yes. They've done the exact same thing you did. They've mocked my voice. They've asked me sexual questions like you just did. They've constantly been annoying me. And they've even made so many mom jokes that I swear to God, I even counted.
You wanna know how many times they've done it?
Over 120. Yes. Over 120. And none of them. Almost none of them were funny at all. Sure, a few of them were okay, but when they kept on doing it over and over and over again, it got on my fucking nerves. And I never ever wanted to hear anybody make a sex joke about my mother again. But of course,
you had to come in and keep on saying all those jokes because you thought it was funny. Funny, 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 I was just joking. Just funny all the way around. Funny, funny, it was just joking.
Now, don't get me wrong. I joke around too.
I also goof off, I could be immature, and hell, I could even be extremely inappropriate at times, especially in NTC stand-up. But I have self-control. I actually know when to stop, and I know when to get back to doing something like academics, like a worksheet or so forth, or after I'm done with the skit in my review, I immediately go back to my analysis. I don't try and spend way too long, and I try not to overstay my welcome. I try not to.
But you, Mickey, you definitely overstayed your fucking welcome.
And you want to know something else? Those guys say some of the stupidest stuff imaginable only because they try to get a reaction at me. They want me to get annoyed and they want me to get angry. Why? Because it makes them feel good. It makes them laugh. They think it's just funny when it clearly isn't to me. Now, joking around is fine, but if you keep doing it over and over and over again, it gets annoying. And the same can be said for lying straight to my face. Like, I've actually had people go like, hey, there's this girl that likes you over there. And I go like, really? But then I found out later that is actually not the case. And then I see the girls going like, come on, gullible Sam. How could you fall for that? I fucking hate that. I hate being lied to. I just fucking hate it.
But they keep doing this stuff because they just say to themselves, oh, Sam won't fight back. He won't fight you. You can just keep doing it all you want. He won't fight back.
Hell, someone even called me a queer, and he even tried to fight me. But guess what? I said no, because I didn't want to fight him because I thought it was pointless and not needed. I don't want to fight anyone. I'm more of a person that likes to fight with words rather than just with my fist, okay? I don't want to fight anybody. But of course, many people just take that as an advantage, going like, okay, he won't fight you, you can just keep saying this stuff over and over. I fucking hate that. It gets on my fucking nerves, and I just wish they would just stop. I wish they would stop with the mom jokes, and I wish they would just stop trying to get a reaction on me because they think it's funny.
Oh, and one more thing.
Back in elementary school, they had a little something called a golden rule. The golden rule was, respect others, and they will respect you. Throughout this entire video,
you have just completely disrespected me. So, why should I respect you back?
Look, Mickey, I didn't want to yell at you. I really didn't. I mean, you can be a nice person. I could see that in you. But you constantly just drove me nuts throughout this entire video. And I just couldn't take it any longer. And I also just can't stand what the people at my school do. I mean, they don't do it as much as they did before, but they still do it. I just wish they would just fucking stop. Look, I don't want to be treated like I'm a walking punchline. I think that's what many people see me, a walking punchline. And I am not a walking punchline. I don't want to be treated like that.
I just want you to treat me with some respect. Respect me like you actually care about me.
Look, I didn't make this YouTube channel just so I could get attention. Okay, maybe a little bit, but for the most part, I made this channel just so I could have my voice heard. I don't do this for money. This is really a hobby of mine. I only do it for fun. And also, I make these videos because not only do I want to entertain the viewers, but I also want to make them feel good, put a smile on their face, and make them laugh. That's why I made this channel, to make people laugh. I love the people that have watched me. I love my subscribers, and I really love them so much. So please, please, Mickey.
Please don't treat me like I'm a walking punchline.
I don't want to be treated like that. I just want to be treated as a human being. A human being that just wants to have fun and just make people laugh. That's it. Please do not treat me like I'm a walking punchline, Mickey. Please.
You're right.
Huh?
You're right. You're right about everything. I actually did think that all the stuff I did was really just funny. But I can see that doing it over and over really does get under your skin. And it really does offend you, and I'm really sorry. I'm sorry that I said all those mom jokes. I'm sorry that I mocked your voice, and I'm sorry for interrupting your review. And I'm sorry that I called you a fucking pussy for, you know, not having a sex life. I'm really sorry. And speaking of that, I've got a confession to make. I've never gotten laid. I lied about the whole thing. I never got laid my entire life.
Really?
And on top of that, I've never actually been kissed by a girl. And also, I've never actually had any friends. I've mostly just been that one guy in the YouTube comment section just starting fights. Just trying to get fast attention. Just being an asshole. But now I see how my asshole behavior can actually affect people like you. And for that, sorry.
That's okay. And hey, if you want me to, I could be your friend.
What? But what about all the stuff I did? The mom jokes, the mocking your voice, but why would you want to...
Hey, as long as you apologized, it's fine. I could see that you could be a nice guy, and you really do look like you need friends.
Actually ever asked me to be a friend before. Do you really mean it?
Of course I do. And I know you can be a nice person. So for that, I'm willing to be your friend.
Thank you. Thank you so much. I've never really had a friend before. Just thank you. I really appreciate it.
You're welcome. Oh, hey, I almost forgot. There actually is one line in this episode that actually just killed me.
What's that?
Why would anyone dislike us?
Oh man, where do we even begin?
Yeah, all the problems with your show can probably fill up a 1,000-page textbook.
First off, your animation is too bright.
And the animation is also very cheap.
Your characters scream too much.
Your characters are obnoxious as hell.
Your stories don't make any goddamn sense.
The voice acting is atrocious.
Oh, and let's not forget the time that you actually had a story revolved around a fucking sandwich.
One long listing of all of Teen Titans Go's problems later.
Whew. Wow. Finally got all the problems with Teen Titans Go off my chest.
Yeah, it actually was pretty fun.
Hey, thanks for being in this review with me.
Yeah. Hey, listen, again, I really enjoy doing this. And also, it really means a lot to finally actually have a friend. I thank you, really. Thank you so much.
You're welcome, Mickey.
Okay, oh man, look at the time. Sorry, it's past my curfew, I gotta go.
Okay, Mickey, see you later. Oh, hey, if you ever need me, let me know.
Thanks. Oh, and hey, if you ever need me, you know where to find me.
I will.
See ya.
Man, what a review. And hey, just remember, guys, if people keep calling you a queer, keep making sex jokes about your mother, and keep on mocking your voice just so they can get a reaction out of you, those aren't your true friends. The ones that legitimately care about you and the ones that check up on you and actually legitimately like you as a person, as a human being, those are your true friends. Alright guys, that's pretty much it. I hope you enjoyed this video, and if you did, give it a like and subscribe to my channel. And also, I would like to thank all the subscribers and all the people that have watched my videos. It really means a lot. I loved all your feedback, and I really thank you from the bottom of my heart. Thank you guys for watching, and as always, I'm the NTC, and mwah. Good night, everybody, and I'll see you guys soon for Season 3.
Motherfuckers doubted me. I told you it was pure Kino. I told you it was a spiritual, emotional journey from beginning to end. You thought I was full of shit. You thought this would be just any other Nostalgia Critic parody video. But no. No. You were proven wrong. You were proven wrong. And I think you owe it to yourself and to Baseball Sam to go give this video a like. And to subscribe, Baseball Sam, it's right here. 17,000 views deserves a lot more. Let's take a look at some of the comments. Let's start by new. I'm gonna fuck your dad, rude. Pretty sure he specifically said don't. post comments like that. NTC more like NPC. Okay. Okay, no more troll comments. Now we're to the actual fan comments. This is a little long. We are the same person. Oof. And that's linking to the big speech. I'm a very sensitive person. Also, if someone made up sex jokes about my family and friends, I would put tape on their mouths and lock them in a cage. This is a pretty fucking funny review. Okay. What you said near the end really connected to me. I live in a world where I feel no one cares about me, especially in school, and I have no friends. Relatable. Oh, does Baseball Sam want to call in to the show right now? Let's see if he wants to hop in a voice call. We can interview him about this video. I asked him if he wants to hop in a voice call. Okay, boys, looks like we're gonna, the man, the myth, the legend himself, Baseball Sam, we're gonna get him on the program right now. The guy who made the video we all just watched. Let's give him a call.
Hi.
Hey, Mr. Baseball Samuel, how are you doing this, Saturday evening, Sunday morning?
I'm doing just fine. It's like 1:21, and I'm actually going to move to another location. Like, my bedroom's not a good place to be talking to anybody right now because my parents are actually sleeping right below me.
Oh, no. We know how loud you tend to get. You better get away from that bedroom.
Yeah, I know. That's why I moved under the bed to make my videos now.
Now, Sam, a lot of people wouldn't know this, but you and I actually live in the same city, and I've invited you to go out bowling many times.
Yes, you have.
Yeah, when are we going bowling? Everybody's waiting for the monkey vlog, Baseball Sam bowling extravaganza.
Have they?
Yeah, people in the chat have been begging for it all night after we watched your video. They say, Monkey, go bowling with this guy. He's great.
Yeah, lots of, like, hindrances here and there. The thing is, in my high school, I'm actually on the baseball team.
Oh, I thought you were graduated from high school by now.
Not yet. Still got to wait a few more months.
Wait, you're telling me that Baseball Sam is actually on the baseball team?
Yes, it's South Granville High School.
Okay. Oh, you don't need to. We don't need to know the high school. It's okay.
Well, what if they actually do want to know? I've seen a bunch of comments going like, "Let's go down to the high school and beat up those bullies."
I guess.
By the way, don't do that. That's not a good way to, like, you know, solve your problems.
No, definitely not. So, were you watching along with us as we just watched your magnum opus?
Yeah, Carson was letting me know, like, hey, have you talked to Monkey recently? Well, now he's on Twitch, and he's talking about, like, hey, he's going to show this video about, like, you know, his fourth wall videos. Like, it's an emotional journey. And
that's right.
This is probably the best parody of the Nostalgia Critic ever. And I was like, oh, God, no, this is not happening. And so, I went on Twitch. I made a Twitch account once. But I kind of forgot about it, and then, you know, Carson told me, so I walked back in and was like, oh, God, he actually is doing it.
So what did you think of my analysis? Was I right? Was I missing a few things? Because this is just one critic to another, you know? This is my interpretation of the video. Is there anything you want to clarify or clear up?
Okay, like, I was seeing a bunch of comments going, like, best parody of, like, Nostalgia Critic ever. And I'll say this. In, like, say, the earlier days, like, when I was, like, getting myself started, like, especially, like, around, like, the first couple seasons, I mean, I did want to be my own thing, but at the same time, yeah, I definitely was, like, you know, like, this huge fan of Doug Walker's work. I know you don't like him that much. But, yeah, you made it very clear. And look, if anyone's getting the impression that, oh, he was just doing this just so he could copy him, no. Look, this gotta be just, it's major coincidences. Maybe, like, in the earlier stuff, I kind of was, like, you know, emulating him in some way. But I kind of, like, really just moved on from that and just, like, say, hey, I just want to be, like, me, myself. So it's nothing like, you know, like, so my videos now, they're not really what you saw on the fourth wall. It's, like, where I get, like, super over-the-top angry, go out and, like, bust a bunch of windows with a baseball bat.
Well, I think that's what makes this video so special is that it is a perfect blend of Nostalgia Critic parody, but then it gets even better when you open up and become the actual you and you're not trying to, you know, rip anybody off. When you're being your authentic self is when the video, I think, really shines and becomes pure Kino.
Yeah, and that's what I've really been trying to do, just be myself. And yet there's still kind of people going like, oh, this guy's the worst example in this category ever. I mean, like, why would you ever take an influence on him? Look, for anybody that's like that, it happened. That's really how I, like, you know, got some inspiration. It wasn't really him. It was also a bunch of other critics, too. There was even, like, this one underrated cartoon reviewer. No, actually, not cartoon reviewer. He actually just reviews movies, like the famous movies. His name's on the British guy, and like he was also an influence.
What's his name? Too. You cut out there for a second.
The Unusual Suspect.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, like he's reviewed like some of the Stuart Little films. He reviewed Indiana Jones: Raiders of the Lost Ark. He's reviewed also like the Star Wars films, like actually the prequels. So
wait, honestly, there's a guy on YouTube who reviewed the Star Wars prequels.
Yes,
and shit.
He gave them all a fair shot, and he's one of the people that's actually said, "I don't think episode one's that bad."
Oh, wow.
Yeah, he's pretty brave man.
No, yeah.
Honestly, I still find him hilarious to this day. I mean, like, he doesn't really make a lot of videos, like, you know, like, one every single week. Like, it actually takes him months to really, like, craft the videos, get the scripts together, and also get all the effects in there. But it's really well worth it. Like, the editing is phenomenal, and the delivery he has on, like, most of the jokes he has is just really hilarious. Like, there's one, like, Stuart Little 2 where, like, the main character, George, is on the soccer team, and one of the kids gets hurt, and so they're looking for somebody to replace him. And so this fat kid goes like, well, we have George. It'd be like having 8 people. I mean, like, he wouldn't be enough. So the Unusual Suspect was like, oh, man, that's a bitch. And so he decided to, like, get him back and go like, hey, well, we got you, you fat fuck. You count as 2. So I guess that thing, and I guess that even things out, doesn't it? And that just had me rolling the floor, honestly.
I find this so interesting. Here I am reviewing your channel, and in turn, you're reviewing somebody else's channel. We have a real Inception-level channel review going on right now.
Yeah, actually, I did dedicate a video to the Unusual Suspect. I actually talked about him, like, twice. One in a video where I was giving, like, you know, like shout-outs to different channels. And then I actually, like, later on in the most recent YouTube Content Creator Month I did about, like, you know, last month, I talked about his most recent video, Top 25 Reasons Why Movie Theaters Suck, which, by the way, I actually still go to movie theaters, and I can understand if some people don't like it, but I still go sometimes.
Yeah, I think we should get him in the call soon, so then I can review you while you review him, and then he can review me, and we'll have an authentic circle jerk going on live on stream.
Yeah, I don't know if it's really going to be that easy. Ross no. Thompson, that's his real name. I don't think he would really be that interested in joining.
Besides, he might not be a fan of Mumkey Jones.
Could be, or maybe another reason. He probably doesn't even know who you are.
Oh, that is a much better reason, actually. There's a very good chance of that.
Well, I think he would be more likely to look up people like, say, I don't know. Honestly, I really don't know. But
Doug
I don't
Walker.
Think he really has ever heard of, like, Mumkey Jones. Or Mumkey Jonas now.
Yeah, perhaps. Let me ask you this. We all just went on this emotional journey with you watching your video. You're still in high school, you said. This video is about a year or two old. Has the bullying cleared up at all? Has it improved or has it gotten worse?
That video came out about just less than 2 years ago, and it's not really like as bad as it really once was. I mean, like, I think I made it a little too over the top talking about how bullying was, but yeah, there were some times where there were some people really giving me a hard time, and yeah, it really was bothering me, but I moved on from that. And even the person that actually was like, you know, he wanted to fight me and stuff like that, and he was the one that, like, you know, was spreading all these, like,
he called you a queer, I believe.
He actually called me worse. I could have actually said anything else. He could have said like, call me like this and that, but I just kept it that. I think one of the issues I kind of had with the ending was that I kind of was a little bit too repetitive, you know, just like saying some of the lines over and over again. Nowadays, I feel like some people were probably watching and go like, okay, we get the message. What are you trying to really say? Can you conclude it?
Well, I'm glad you didn't say all the things that he called you, because after all, we do live in a society, and Mom would end up freaking if you said such
language. Yeah, yeah. The thing is, I actually eventually told her about all this kind of stuff, and she didn't really take it too well, but she didn't really cry or anything like that. She was just more like, he's a jackass anyway. Mm.
Have you shown your YouTube channel to anybody that you go to school with? Have they seen this video? Maybe they repented they, for their sins.
Yes. There's some people in my school that do know that I make my YouTube channel, and even my parents know. Like, here's the thing. Here's the funny story. My mom saw this one video I made, then also had a cameo with another YouTuber. His name is Equestron, and I was talking about one of the Equestron.
Is that a brony YouTuber by chance?
Yes. Okay. It is. Okay, so I was talking about Roller Coaster of Friendship from like Equestria Girls, and so it's like it was a 42-minute video. It should have been shorter, but I really tried to make it shorter. I just couldn't do it. So anyway, I made the video, and I think around like at the end of the video, when I was just about to conclude it, like Equestria came on, did his cameo, went on for I think like 4 or 5 minutes, and to my mom, she said that was the best part of the video, and she actually found him more hilarious than me, and was like, I want to watch more of him than you, and I'm like, oh. Come on.
Cucked by your own mother. I can't believe it. This is worse than what Mickey claimed he did to your mom.
Like nowadays Mickey's just like, okay, the whole point of Mickey really, like why he was being this way was actually more just a reflection on like how some people can get so hypocritical when they like, you know, make fun of you and all that kind of stuff. Like how bullies really are. Like they try to be like very intimidating and domineering and really try to bring you down. When in reality, some of them might actually live some pretty pathetic lives of their own. Like they probably don't have that many friends. They might have this bottle of anger inside, and they feel like the best way to get rid of all that is by making other people miserable, I guess. I mean, not all bullies are like savage monsters or anything like that, but some of them do have their own kind of, you know, backstory. Sometimes they have like horrible families they live in. Sometimes they just don't really know how to express themselves that well, so they just, you know, try to push people away. So anyway, the people that were giving me a hard time before, they moved on from it. And even the person that was like, you know, giving me most of the mom jokes like over 100 times, he's moved on from it. Like even he acknowledges that he was being an asshole, and we kind of made things up. We're not like best friends or anything, but we both moved on.
Did you ever consider maybe like asking one of your teachers to show the video in class in front of everybody?
Hell no. No.
Why not? Because I think it would be like a good lesson for all the... for all of your peers to take in, like, hey, bullying sucks, and here's, we can all be friends.
No, they would flip. If some people have not been watching my channel, they know that I curse a lot, and I do not think that the teachers would really be comfortable with showing that.
True.
I mean, it's definitely something like students are fine with, and I'm sure those teachers probably do it in private, but when like in like school matters and stuff like that, they do not accept those kind of things.
And besides, Beast Boy was shaking his butt at the camera too. That would have been inappropriate.
Yeah, look, here's the thing. Like, the main thing about that episode, like, the review and the entire thing, it was really a performance. I don't like the episode. I've never liked it, even when I first saw it for the first time. And even nowadays, it still just kind of gives me, like, ugh, what are you doing? And that Beast Boy scene, you know, shaking his ass to the camera, like, I was like, why? Why did you try that?
Right.
Like again, the review was more acting, and, of course, the anchor was just, you know, more for comedy's sake. But I can understand how some people might go like, oh, man, this is so cringy. Why is he getting so mad about this cartoon and stuff like that? It's not real.
Well, I think to stand out, you have to show passion in your review. If you were just to give a mild-mannered discussion of the episode, I don't think it would have 17,000 views right now. I think people –
Yeah, exactly.
You have to play up your emotions.
Yeah, of course. Like, any person that wants to get into reviewing has to at least show just a bit of passion. And not just in acting, but also, like – in their writing, with their scripts, with their editing, what they talk about, what they like, what they don't like. If they actually didn't really show any passion at all and were just like Stephen Wright, if he actually had no original, like, you know, material and was just like, okay, now we're going to talk about this one episode that none of you care about. And you know what? I don't either. It sucks. Goodbye. Give me money. Like, if people were more like that, then YouTube would have probably died 3 years ago.
Right. I think if you're okay with it, can we open up the questions to the chat who just watched your video and have been watching our interview? Should we let them hit some questions your way? We'll throw some baseball questions at you and see if you can hit a couple home runs.
You saw my recent video, didn't you?
Oh, no. Which one?
Oh, like the one I like top five. What was it again? It was like a top five list, and at the very end – oh, wait, I remember. It was top five best, like, baseball ejections. Like, the thing is, despite the fact I'm called Baseball Sam 1, I rarely do baseball videos, which is, like, right. The real big ironic thing itself. And
have
so
you considered changing the name of your channel to Nostalgia Teen Critic?
No, it's still gonna stay Baseball Sam 1.
Okay. Why number one?
And besides, I'm just like more accustomed to just saying NTC, and even right. at this point, I just rather prefer Sam. Like kind yeah. of begin. Like if some people have been watching my videos, they kind of noticed that it kind of goes back and forth between maybe NTC and then Sam sometimes. I really don't care. If anybody wants to call me like the autistic sperm of reality, they can go ahead.
All right, we have a couple questions about the video. Epic ZD wants to know, is Mickey's character a closet homosexual and bullies Sam because he's insecure about his sexuality?
Okay, the thing is, Mickey's not a homosexual. He's quite literally into the girls. Like, the main part of him was that he's supposed to be, like, this really pathetic person who, like, talks a big game. When in reality, he's just like that roommate that constantly masturbates in your bathroom.
Right, I hate that guy. Happens too often.
Yeah, house meeting, we're not doing this again. No more masturbating. We need to talk about this now.
Right. I've had that conversation many times. I've been on both ends of that conversation.
Churtgurt,
let's not go into that. Churtgurt wants to know, was the video satire?
Satire, yes. It was more just like, you know, again, like I said before, it was more mostly performance. But that very end when I was really talking about like what stuff that happened before, and the main lesson I was trying to say is, like, don't really be beat down. Don't treat people like a walking punchline, like, just because, like, you know, you're thinking that, oh, they're not going to fight back. Like, that was really, like, at the very end, that was, like, you know, me, realistically. That's when I went off script and actually just said, hey, this is really what I want to say. Here what I have to say.
Oh, so but the ending wasn't scripted. You were just speaking from the heart.
Yes. Like, part of it was scripted, of course, but, like, you know, the Mickey parts. Of course, like, you know, going back and forth and stuff like that. That was actually one of the hardest things to do, like, you know, get that one right. Like, you know, to actually, like, you know, say what I was going to say and have him show up on the screen and stuff like that. It was really hard to do that, especially when I was just using the phone at the time.
Help is not available points out, you know, you have a bit of naughty language in your videos. Do you record your videos while your parents are home, or do you wait for them to go out to, like, bowling night or something?
Okay, one, they never really go bowling at all.
Oh,
it's only for, like, special occasions. And right. second, it depends. Sometimes they might be home, and I'll still do videos. Like, I moved onto my, like, you know, my bunk bed. Like, I know, it's strange. I don't have anybody sleeping in the room with me. No brothers come in there. They don't sleep in there, so kind of pointless to have the bunk bed, but it's still cool. It has a desk underneath it, and I use that as, like, you know, the base where I make my videos now.
So are your parents okay with the swearing in your videos, or would they be upset if they heard it?
Of course, being parents, they're going to be like, okay, don't be too much like a sailor, but they understand that. And besides, I'm 18 years old, going to be out of, like, you know, out of North Carolina, out of their house in, like, you know, in 5 months, and I'm heading off to Western Carolina, so.
Oh, wow. Are you afraid that maybe future job prospects might be in trouble if, you know, you try to get a job at Google and they find out you say so many naughty words online, you might not get the job?
I don't really think anybody's going to really remember me as, like, someone like, oh, I don't think people really remember 2,000 subscriber people, so.
Oh, I think all of us will remember you for a long time. So maybe you'll have to ask one of us to give you a job.
Well, we'll see about that. First job, actually, fun fact, first job I ever had was at a strawberry farm, picking strawberries.
Oh, slave labor, fun.
It only lasted for just about 2 months, that's it. I mean, it did give me a good tan, I'll give it that.
This guy wants to know, the bacon-crafted curtain, how much more vulgar will Baseball Sam get after he moves out? We've heard the words you're willing to say in your parents' house. What kind of words will you evolve into once you move out?
Okay, here's the thing. Like, I'm not always vulgar with, like, every single person, especially with, like, you know, my family. Like, I'll say a couple things, like, say, like, they're fine with, like, words like damn or shit. It's not really that bad. Mm-hmm. But if I really went off and, like, saying, like, the F word and the C word right to their faces, like, directly to their faces, then, yeah, they would have a problem with that. In fact, I don't even say the C word, really. No. I think it's the most offensive word ever, and I don't have the stomach to say it.
What about like the, like, N-word? Would your parents let you say the N-word?
I am never going to say the N-word. Like, never. I have never said it.
Is that worse than the C-word, or are they about the same?
They're both in the same way. They're both, like, the most offensive words.
Right.
I mean, of course, the C-word is, like, you know, the worst, like, it's the worst, like, offensive word. You can, like, not just call women that, but the same thing goes for anybody else, men, right. Whatever. Like, nobody should really call anybody that, unless it's really someone who's, like, a big scum of the earth. And as for the N-word, no, nobody should really be doing it. In fact, here's the thing. Some people in my school, especially some white people, actually are just going around saying it like it's just regular conversation. I'm like, what the hell
Wait,
are you doing?
Did they have the N-word pass?
I have never heard of the N-word pass.
Oh. Yeah, but I agree. In terms of
But even if I actually was given the N-word pass, I wouldn't take it. I'd just throw it in the garbage.
Right. Or sell it to somebody so that they could use it.
Or more like, I don't want anybody else to use it.
Oh. Well, I think in pure numbers, you know, the C word is offensive to 100% of people. The N word is only bad for like 15%.
Here.
15%? I thought it'd be bigger.
Just in terms of America, so yeah, I think by pure numbers alone, the C word is 85% more offensive. Frostzilla Gaming, thank you so much for the $38 donation. That's fucking amazing. You are the hero of the day, Frost. If you have any questions for Baseball Sam Frost, throw it in the chat.
Sam
we'll
Frost
take care
now?
Of it.
Am I Baseball Sam Frost now?
Yes, Baseball Sam Frost. It's the,
Wait,
the
I
cool
thought it was
version
baseball
of you.
Kid 567. Like, you remember the Pizza Party podcast you went on and you didn't even remember what my name was?
That's right. I did talk about you on the Pizza Party podcast, didn't
and you
I?
Said that. And you said that to... You said that to Rebel Taxi himself, and I'm like, oh my god, biggest guy in the animation community, and now he's gonna remember me as Baseball Kid 56, blah blah.
What did I say about you on that podcast? I don't remember.
No, you were like saying stuff like, I've seen some parody reviews like Teen Nostalgia Critic, and you know what? His videos are better than anything. And it's like, okay. And it's like this 15-year-old kid who's doing an impression, and it's fucking amazing. All that.
At least like, I'm consistent.
Yes, and I still remember that. Like, I think one person in, like, comment section, I think it was, like, during lunch at that time, like, in, like, one of the school days, and I just got a notification, like, hey, Monkey, like, just talked to you on the Pizza Party podcast. And I was like, wait, what? And I was like, yeah, go ahead, check it out. So it's on, like, the Pizza Party podcast. I think it was the 95th episode, and you were on it with, like, I know one of his friends.
With Izzy. Izzy was on there. Nolan, I think.
Oh, right. Okay.
Yeah.
I was trying to remember.
Good episode.
Yeah.
All right, let's see if there are any other questions for
you. You know, before they decided to actually bring Ben the Looney on there.
I'm not familiar. The only episode I've heard is the one I was on.
Okay, all right. So
not a big fan.
Well, we've now just established that aside from that one episode he's in, he has never seen any other episode on the Pizza Party podcast.
No.
Egotist.
I've also appeared on the official podcast, and I didn't even listen to that. I didn't even
listen
to that episode.
Nah, you're too busy trying to go after Jane Goodall, probably.
Yeah, me and Jane Goodall. I'm trying to get her on my podcast.
Wait, how old is that woman?
Probably like 90.
Something? Really? She's still alive?
Oh, yeah, for sure. I'm keeping her alive with my love.
Well, okay. I thought she was like in like late 80s or something like that.
Jared James wants to know who's on first. I think that's a baseball question.
That's an Abbott and Costello reference, isn't it?
Oh, okay.
Yeah, obviously.
I thought it was the first baseman.
I don't think
baseman.
I've ever actually really been given that question. And sometimes, okay, if someone actually really did come up to me and ask me that question, if I was like, you know, in the crankiest mood and said, who's on first? And I said, not you, with your girl.
Oh, like some of the inner Mickey is coming out.
Yeah, the thing is, like, some of the characters I had kind of, like, you know, were, like, a combination of, like, you know, some aspects of what I kind of am.
Right.
Like, sometimes, you know, so, like, you know, like, Bizarro Sam, like, you know, the bumbling idiot, but always, like, you know, nice to others and complimentary and stuff like that. Then there's Alex, who, like, you know, is, like, you know, the intellectual and stuff like that, but still can actually kind of be, you know, a little bit indicative, I think. I don't know. And, like, that's how I, like, you know, based off those characters, I guess.
Cuss Jojo says, you know, that response about you making the joke about the guy's girlfriend, he says that it breaks the golden rule. Do you still follow the golden rule after all this time?
Oh, respect others and they'll respect you.
Right.
Look, I really wouldn't say that to anybody's face unless they really were like, you know, a complete, like total asshole to me.
They
like,
kept asking you who's on first over and over again.
Let's see. Who's on first? I don't know.
Right.
Yeah, who's on first? And then who's on third and stuff like that? Yeah. And
then you would say, I'm going to go fuck your girlfriend.
No. That's what you would say.
That's what I would. That's right. Yeah, you know me so well. How big of a Yankee fan are you?
Like what?
Do you like the Yankees, the New York Yankees?
Yes, I never thought I actually made that obvious.
Okay. Do you dream of one day playing for them professionally?
Yeah, that was actually a dream that I had like long before I started YouTube. I was like, you know, kind of saying like, I want to play with Jeter and all that kind of stuff. But of course, reality comes in to smack you in the face, and now I've realized I'm probably not even gonna play baseball. I mean, I tried. I mean, like, I did get on the high school team like 4 years in a row, so that's still fine. But I never really gotten like, you know, any calls with like, you know, scouts or anything like that. They never really noticed.
No, not yet.
The thing is, I don't think any scouts really do show up to some of our games. I mean, like, maybe they are, but they're just kind of hidden somewhere and I can't really make them out. And anyway, I was more just a first baseman and a pitcher, and I never really got to play that much.
Keep
and the
up
most
the
I ever
good
played
work.
Was like in like my junior year last year. But even then, it wasn't like, you know, like sparkling like 393 or like 500 batting average or something like that. I think
you
I
say
averaged
you play
like,
first baseman and pitcher?
Yeah.
Those are the most important roles in the whole thing. How what's your batting average? Are you good the whole all around?
Let me think. I think in my second year, I did get some playing time because one of the first baseman who was starting that year was my sophomore year. He got himself into a car accident, and so I took over for him in like a few games. He was fine.
God.
He just hit his. He was fine. He just hit his head. He didn't break his leg or anything like that.
Too bad.
He did come back. But I played a few games, and I actually did get some hits. And I think I ended the season with like a 294 average. So then after he was gone, he actually was supposed to be on the varsity team in my junior year. But apparently, here's the system. That's how it works in my school. You have to take 3 classes and pass all of them in order to, like, you know, get on any sports team in the spring. He didn't do that. He took 2 classes, and that meant he couldn't, you know, try out for any of these teams.
He was a high schooler, so, only enrolled in 2 classes.
Yes, and the thing was, like, eventually, the final nail in the coffin was that he ended up hurting himself again. Like, I think he hurt his foot or something, and he was in a cast. And that was pretty much it for his high school career.
What are the chances that you sabotaged his schedule and also cut his breaks?
I didn't know such thing, okay?
I don't know. Sounds suspicious, Sam. I think you might have tried to usurp the baseball power.
Oh, please. No, I wouldn't do that.
No, you're a good boy. You didn't do nothing.
Yes, I'm not one of those people that goes into the bathroom and vapes and, you know, like behind the teacher's back and just goes like...
People vape in the bathroom at school?
Wait, what?
People are vaping in the bathroom at school?
Not just in like, you know, in the bathrooms. Like, some people actually try to sneak in class. Like, I've seen a couple people actually, like, you know, make it look like, oh, this is just a flash drive of my computer. It's not real. So it's like these, like, little rectangular black things with maybe a stripe on it, and it has, like, a little dot, and then just, like, kind of, like, suck and put it in their mouth, like... And then they just kind of keep it in there and like...
Do you at least, like, you know, like, tell the teacher or the principal about this? This is unruly behavior.
I don't know. Like, even if I did try, they probably would have just gone like, why'd you tell everyone, Sam? Snitch, snitch, snitch. And I'm like, okay, I don't have time for this. They still do it anyway. And eventually... Actually, the thing is, I did see a couple of them get caught once. But, yeah, they did get repercussions for that. But it didn't matter anyway. They still went back and did it anyway.
Here's what you got to do. I think you have to write an anonymous letter listing every single student who has a vape in their backpack and send it to your teacher, the principal, the police station, and then I think the search dogs will come in and take care of it. Nobody will even know you did it.
Yeah. It's not really like an epidemic or anything like that. I think it's just maybe like a handful in the school. It just happens to be people that I know.
I think a vape is a gateway drug to methamphetamine and power crystals. Like, it's not a joke, especially at such a young age, an impressionable young age.
Especially when I've heard a report. I actually read an article where it said it actually has small traces of marijuana in the vape.
Like, that's no laughing matter.
Yeah, I know, but it doesn't matter. Like, I bet some people probably do know what's in it, but they just still do it anyway because it just tastes good and stuff like that. I mean, like, that's how the 40s and 50s got away with some of their cigarette commercials. It just tastes good. It has a wonderful taste. You'll love it. I mean, why do you think the Flintstones tried it in the 60s?
I bet if the Flintstones were still on the air today, they'd be vaping up a storm.
Yeah, like, Wilma, can I get some money? I need to get a new vape at the store. And then the bird will be just coming like, it's an addiction.
If poor Pebbles and Bam Bam would be vaping themselves, so young, so innocent.
Yeah, like, going from, like, innocent little, like, you know, like, children, like, oh, I will never let anything happen to you, And now they're like around like 16 or 17. They probably have tattoos and nose rings, and they're just like vaping up a storm.
Now,
here's our 21st century, folks.
Somebody in the chat was curious. We both live in North Carolina. It's a very diverse region. The vaping epidemic, is that spread out across all demographics, or is it like one type of person who's doing it?
Again, like I said before, I only know it's just like a few people that do vape. I mean, I'm sure it's not every single person in the school. Right. Like, again, like I'm sure they probably are just pretty cheap to get. Like,
is it just the white kids doing it?
Huh?
Is it just the white kids who are doing it?
No, it's not just white kids. It's black kids, Hispanic. It doesn't matter what race. Like, right. I'm sure anybody could probably just get a vape if they have like a couple bucks or something.
All colors of the rainbow are falling victim to these evil vapes.
Apparently, I guess. And there's also even some that like they go further. It's not just vaping. Like, some people go out and party, they'll drink, and they'll even like get some weed on the side, maybe some cocaine. I don't know. But
would you say that like 13% of the students at school do over 50% of the vaping?
I honestly don't know the real percentage. Like, we never really did a survey. Like, okay, who's vaping and who's not? We never really did that. Like, again, I only just know a handful. That's it.
What would be your gut feeling?
Probably my gut feeling on what?
Like 13% probably doing about 50% of the vaping.
I'm thinking it probably might be less than 13%. Would be around, let's say, might be like around maybe like 5%. I really don't know.
How could such a small minority do so much of the crime?
I mean, okay, vaping really isn't a crime. Again, it's just like, if they want to vape, that's fine. I mean, it's the same with smoking. Again, vaping is seen as like an alternative to smoking. It's not really like, you know, something that kills you, but we all found out.
That sounds like they're lacing it with marijuana, dude. I mean, marijuana can kill you. You can get cancer from that.
There's some people that actually do take marijuana. There's actually people that take medical marijuana in order to deal with some kind of illnesses. And some people just more do it. Like, actually, like the one major drug that could probably kill you the most is like, you know, heroin. I mean, like, vaping and weed, you'll get on a high, but it's not really something that might, you know, potentially like kill you unless you actually are stuffing like, you know, not just like a handful of grass, but like, let's say an entire acre into your mouth.
Yeah, no, I mean, I've done a little bit of research into drug use. I think more people have died from marijuana than heroin.
Are you sure? Because
that's what I read on the latest Pew poll. I read something. Maybe it was a troll. I don't know. I'm pretty sure that's what I read.
Yeah, well, look, obviously, I do know that some people are doing it, but honestly, I can't really change their minds. If they want to go have fun, they can. Like, here's the thing. Lots of people, like, you know, back in, like, in the 20th century, they still did the same thing anyway. Some smoked. Some still did drugs. Some did acid.
Do you think your parents did any drugs like that before they had you?
Wait, No, my parents got smart and never really took any drugs, but like when they had me, like, my mother was not one of those people that, like, I'll still smoke and drink anyway, despite the fact I'm pregnant. No, they're smart people.
Your parents didn't, your mom didn't drink while she was pregnant with you.
No, she did not. Of course not.
How do you know? You weren't there.
Mom told me straight in my face, like, no, don't be doing this kind
my
of
mom
stuff.
Lied to me. No, my mom smoked and drank when she was pregnant with me. She lied to me about it till I saw the home video.
Are you sure?
Oh, I saw it. It explains a lot about me.
Well, I'm guessing Miss Mumkey wasn't much of an angel, I guess.
No, yeah, Miss Mumkey. We're married and she's my mom.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Okay, I think really the only person that really like did any of that kind of stuff, you know, like getting high, getting drunk and like partying and stuff like that, was really just my dad. But again, that was back when he was just in high school and college, and that was back when he was just like more concerned about getting laid rather than, you know, just being like a clean kid.
Your dad was more concerned about getting laid in college? Did he tell you that?
It was in the 80s. Every single boy, like they were always like into these, like, you know, hair metal bands, and of course there'd be songs like "Girls, Girls, Girls," like, you know, Motley Crue and stuff like that. And of course they bought into it, and of course they were, you know, those like party dudes, like, "Hey, let's smoke something up, man!" Like, he got into that. In fact, he had a mullet one time. Okay,
your dad had a mullet.
Yes, he did.
Have you considered getting your dad on a video? Maybe like do an interview about the 80s. Nostalgia Teen Critic reviews the 80s with help from Nostalgia Dad.
No, he's got better things to do than actually do.
Better things to do than bond with his son?
No, and better things to do than actually, you know, again, no, it's not like that. It's more just like he's got, like, you know, a job or anything. Like, sometimes it's like, he works at home, but he'll sometimes go to, like, you know, the company, and sometimes he'll actually travel to different cities. Like, I don't think he really has time for an interview.
Okay.
Because he's already interviewing everyone else. He's actually one of, like, you know, the higher-ups, like one of those people that actually is, like, a boss to some other people, but he still has bosses of his own. So he's, like, one of the major, like, you know, people that works at his company.
Would you be upset if you found out your dad was secretly sneaking off to go bowling with some other guy's son and not you?
He'd be the first to tell you that he would suck at bowling. Okay. Actually,
for all you know.
He was much better at actually playing Madden video games rather than just playing bowling. And besides, we don't really bowl that much. We'll bowl maybe a couple times, like, say, in a year. But it's not like a thing like, oh, we go to the local bowling alley and just, like, you know, hit one up. It's not like, you know, like Nico's brother, like, in the Battle of Four. It's like, hey. It's like, Nico, can we go bowling, man?
Hey, Baseball Sam, cousin, you want to go bowling?
I was like, hell no. Fuck no.
Right.
I am done with your bowling. I am done with this. Fuck off and get yourself whatever. Yeah, no, I'm not a bowling person.
So instead of inviting you bowling, I should invite you to the batting cages. That's what you want to do.
Yeah, look, here's the thing. Man, I've always been, man, I've been busy, like, you know, videos. Right. Then there's baseball, having to travel to different places. It's not always, like, easy to, like, really, like, get some of the stuff, like, you know, the very ambitious ideas and go, like, oh, I want to hang out with this person on a certain day. I mean, I'm glad some people can do that, but there's some other people that probably have a lot of other stuff on their plane that just don't really have the time. Right. And that's just kind of where I am right now. Like, you know, school work again. Like, see, it's the senior year. I want to graduate. I want to pass my last math course. It's, like, the hardest class I have to take this semester. And I don't want to fail it.
Right,
I don't.
Right.
It's pre-calc. I don't want to fail it.
Yeah, usually, so, I mean, I get what you're saying. I think it's a pretty common thing. Usually, pretty much all the time, when I invite somebody to hang out, they're always pretty busy, like, with school and stuff, even if they're graduated. So, like,
yeah,
I get it. Like, it happens.
Yeah, but you still get people that actually are free and go, like, oh, yeah, sure. Why not?
Yeah. We had a donation. There's a girl named Ms. Ironside who wanted to let you know. Sam, I don't know if she just got out of the shower. It says, Sam makes me so wet. Tell him to hit me up, please. I guess this girl has a crush on you.
How old is this girl?
Well, she has enough money to donate, so I imagine she's got to be 18 or older.
If it's okay, I don't really know how to respond to that.
Do you? She says she's 26. Are you interested?
No, no thanks.
Little too old.
And okay. I rather look. The thing is about me, I've never really like been dating anyone for like years. But if I really had to date someone right now, like I would rather prefer someone like close to my age range and not really someone who's like 26, has their own house and stuff like that, or someone that lives like, you know, 700 miles away. Like I'm done with internet dating.
Well, I was gonna ask, but after watching your video, I'm afraid to ask about your sex life. I think it might be offensive. Can we ask about your dating life?
It's still non-existent. It's still non-existent.
Non-existent.
Yes.
You've done some online dating, though, it sounds like.
Look, I'm not throwing myself or anything like that. Like, here, finally, just get rid of my V-card already. Like, no, I'm not doing that.
Now, you should hold on to that V-card. It's very valuable. You got to find a girl who's worth it.
Until I actually find the right person to be with. Don't just be with this one night and with this one girl that probably you won't even talk to ever again after that.
And it's certainly not with Ms. Ironside. That would be a wasted V-card for sure.
Yeah, I'm sure this girl's nice and everything, but again, 26-year-old probably doesn't even live in North Carolina.
Probably
has her own life and everything like that. It's a little complicated to, like, you know, go, like, okay, I'll get myself play tickets. I'm going to go all the way, like, 500 miles just so I can get late, and then I'll come all the way back. Definitely going to be, like, you know, something that's worth it.
Do you even have the money to buy a plane ticket to go do that?
Oh, hell no.
No, of course not.
No, plane tickets are always expensive. Like, I don't even remember the last time I actually was on a plane.
Ms. Ironside said that she lives in South Carolina. Maybe she can just drive up to your house and meet your parents.
No, let's not do that.
Okay.
If they actually, like, if this girl actually did show up to my parents' door, they'd be like, okay, who is this girl? What have you been doing, Sam? And I just, like, it would cause a lot of trouble. Like, no, I don't think that's going
to
happen.
It sounds like she's closer in age to your mom than you anyway.
Huh?
I think she's closer in age to your parents than to you, so it wouldn't even make any sense.
My parents are both 47.
Okay. No, I think that math adds
up. There's also a couple of comments going like, all these sex jokes make it seem like that this mother is hot and everything like that. And I was like, why are you thinking that my 47-year-old mom is hot as fuck?
Well, the implication is that if everybody at school is bragging about banging your mom, maybe she is attractive.
Yeah, okay, the thing is, like, it was only just a few people. It was more just jokes. Like, you know, middle school kind of humor. Like, the stuff you're supposed to grow out of when you go to high school.
So your mom's not hot, then?
No, okay, I'm not saying that. I'm like, okay, it's a little weird to say, like, if your mom's hot or not, especially when you're like, you know, I'm the son of that mother, so it's not really.
Yeah,
like,
no, yeah, you're right. It's probably kind of weird.
Yeah, like I've never really, like those kind of sexual questions or anything like
that.
Like, here's the most, like, most awkward moment in my life in sixth grade was, like, there was one girl who is really nice. Her name's, like, Hannah. She's a blonde girl, blue eyes. She actually is going to go to college soon, too. And wow. We had, like, a health class together in sixth grade. And there was one time where she pulled me aside, and we were talking for a bit. And then she just comes right out of the blue and says, can you explain to me what sex is? And I'm like, wait, what? And, like, there was a bunch of other girls, like, right behind her. And I knew they were, like, trying to do this just to get, like, some sort of laugh. So it's like the naive person I was, I just went ahead and did it.
Yeah, did you educate her properly? No.
It was not sixth grade. It was actually ninth grade. Whoops. It was.
Oh, okay. Big difference.
So it was ninth grade. It was my freshman year. So I went ahead and started to explain it in my own way.
How do you explain that to a ninth grade girl? What did you say?
I just kind of just went up in front and just said, like, again, the only real sex talk I ever really got was, like, with my dad. And even then, it wasn't, like, the typical birds and the bees talk. He basically just told me a story of, like, the first time he got laid in seventh grade.
Oh, whoa, wow.
Yeah, pretty much, like, it was some sort of, like, college girl, and she already was having this boyfriend. Apparently, this boyfriend knew my dad. It was like, hey, show this young guy a good time. And so it happened. Yeah, it was basically that kind of talk. And seventh grade me was just like, what?
Wait, your dad told you this story while you were in seventh grade?
Yes, he did. He's not like that typical dad, like, you know, like, all that kind of stuff. He'll curse and everything like that. Like, okay, he's not like a hillbilly or anything like that, drinking beer and stuff. He's a professional guy. Like, he's one of those people that has – he does have tattoos. But I'll cover them up when he actually goes in the office. Like, he actually is strictly, like, serious about other stuff. He's a disciplinarian of, you know.
Sam, I think we should get your dad to speak to the police. Seventh grade, he would have been 12. A college student would have been 19 or 20.
It was just a fun little story and stuff like that.
Fun little story. This is sexual assault.
It's not. No, it's not. And, like, looking back on it, it was actually pretty hilarious. It was like, oh, my God, this is really how I got my birds and the bees talk.
I don't, Sam, if my dad got raped, I wouldn't say it was hilarious. I would be mortified.
No. He didn't get raped. It was more like, I think it was just more like the girl was saying, like, hey, do you want to do this and that? And, of course, dad being like, you know, I think he was probably naive at the time. And, like, again, this was his first time. So he went like, why not? Like, it wasn't sexual assault. He actually agreed to it. It was consentful. There was no rape or anything like that. If it was, he would have told me. He didn't say that. It was just a basic one-night stand, basically.
Okay. So did he tell you this while you were in seventh grade, like, because he wanted you to try to beat his high score or something, or what?
No, it was not. It was just more like a car ride, and we were just trying to, like, you know, have a conversation or something like that. And then he just started talking about, like, what happened to him when he was, like, my age and stuff.
Right. Has he talked to this about with a therapist?
No therapist. No.
No. Does he think you're a therapist?
No, I'm not a therapist. It was basically just a father and son talk. Right. Like, again, he's not like, you know, like those really awful dads, but he's not really like, you know, the stereotypical, you know, goofy dad. It's more just in between.
So when that girl in ninth grade asked you about sex, did you tell them the story of your dad having sex with an adult?
No, I did not. I just got, like, some, I just told, like, you know, some basic things, like what would happen. Like, they were more curious about, like, so, like, how does sex actually work? Like, what do you do? And so I was just going, well, like, I was extremely embarrassed. I was blushing and my face was red.
Oh, no.
The girls behind me, her were laughing, and I just didn't really know what to do. So I just tried to, like, keep it PG, I guess. And so, of course, they
the
were like,
PG,
you know, giggling
sex
and all that.
Talk.
I guess. And it's just, after that, I went to class and I was like, what the fuck just happened?
So, did those girls ask you for any more sexual-based questions.
Look, looking back on it, I realized they knew. They knew about this kind of stuff. They just wanted to see what I would do under that pressure. They just wanted to do it for a quick laugh.
So, like, they never came up to you after class and said, like, hey, Sam, that thing you taught us, can you, like, show us how it's done? And then you're like, oh, okay.
No.
Nothing like that?
I wish.
You wish?
No, I'm kidding.
Oh, okay.
Like, it didn't happen like that. It was more just, like, you know, for laughs and stuff like that. Like, there again, there were some girls that were sweet, and they were fine. It's just, like, they were just doing it for, like, you know, just to get a giggle or something like that. Maybe they were bored, I guess.
Yeah. Well, at least you taught them.
I can't. Okay, again, I'm sure they knew about it. They just wanted to see me, like, you know, try to explain it in my own way.
Right.
I don't know. I don't really know.
You don't want to explain it to us the way you explained it to them?
No, I am not doing that.
Okay,
I'm sure everyone who's watching your Twitch right now probably has a good idea what it is.
I think we have a lot of virgins in my chat, actually. I think they could really use your advice.
Oh, even the virgins in your chat probably know how it works. They've just never done it yet.
No, yeah, you're probably right.
Yeah, and also, here's the thing. That girl even asked me, like, do you masturbate? And I was like, no.
She asked you that. To your face.
Yes, she asked me straight to my face, and I was just like, "Why are you asking me this?"
You should have said, "Yeah, I do," but not to you, bitch, and then walked out of the room.
That's not what I would have done. Oh, no, that again, that's what you would have done.
Oh yeah, that's what I did do.
Again, you said it.
When I was in middle school, my mom wanted to have the talk. She asked me if I masturbated. I said, "Not to you, bitch," and I walked out of the room.
No, you did not.
I swear to God, I did. I did.
Oh my goodness.
Yeah. To my own mom.
Oh God.
Joke's on her though, because I really was.
Oh boy, I did not need to hear that.
So what are your plans for college? You think you're gonna get a girlfriend in college, or do you think you're just gonna wait until it happens naturally?
I guess maybe just wait for it eventually. Like, again, I'm not gonna force it or anything like that. And again, if I'm gonna, like, lose the V card, it's not going to be with someone that's just, like, you know, one night stand, know this girl for, like, maybe a few hours, and then they just leave, and you'll never see them again. No, I don't want it to be like that.
Okay.
Like, that's not, like, the main thing. Like, the main thing I want to do, like, main things I want to do when I actually get into college is, one, graduate, of course, two, maybe get some friends, and third, maybe, just maybe, find the potential love in my life. Like, I'm not, again, not forcing it. I'm just going to let, you know, life take its course and just, like, you know, if it actually happens, then great. If it doesn't, then okay, fine. Maybe I can, like, find other ways. I don't know.
Do you have any vision in your mind of, like, what the love of your life would look like? Like, a certain type of girl, certain race, or anything?
I'm more into the girls that actually, like, you know, they're nice.
Right, okay.
Let's say they're not, like, super tall or anything like that. No. They're just kind of, like, maybe, like, just about, you know, where I am at.
How tall are you?
They have a good sense of humor. They're really sweet. They're smart and everything. Like, it doesn't matter what hair color they have. It doesn't matter what skin color they have.
Okay.
It doesn't matter if they actually like the certain, like, you know, the clothes or anything like that.
What if they don't like the Yankees? Is that a no deal?
Like, that's not really going to matter much in a relationship, really. Yeah. Like, I'm sure, like, if I actually do find it, like, someone who probably doesn't even give a crap about baseball, then it's fine. It doesn't matter. Like,
baseball Sam could fall in love with a girl who doesn't even like baseball. You don't want baseball Samantha?
Baseball Samantha?
Yeah, wouldn't that be your dream girl?
Yeah. Actually, funny story about the Samantha part. One time I actually had a birthday, and my dad, being the jokester that he is, I actually got my sense of humor from him. He pretty much got him a cake, and just for a gag, he gave it to me, and it said, "Happy birthday, Samantha."
Was that your birthday when you were going into seventh grade?
No, that was, like, when I was, like, I think 13 years old.
Oh, okay.
I think it was around there.
Yeah, right, and around seventh grade.
It was more just for a laugh, and of course, I pointed out, I was like, oh, my God. It was like this very disappointed face, like, why did you do this to me? You betrayed me.
Oh, yeah, I think at 13, it's a bit too young for a joke like that. You're still developing. Your hormones will act up. I probably would have cried.
Look, looking back on it, it was hilarious, of course. Like, when you look back on stuff, like at the time, you probably didn't like it. You probably thought it was embarrassing. But when you look back on it now, you find, actually, you know what? That was pretty hilarious.
Yeah, I think that happens to your dad a lot. Like, in the moment, something seems horrible and upsetting. But then when you look back, you start laughing.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's like the story of your dad's life, it sounds like.
He was the party animal, and he actually was doing pretty terrible in school at one point. But eventually he got his act together, started actually getting better grades, eventually got into college, did get some degrees, and of course he now has the job that I told you earlier.
Hell yeah. You want to follow in his footsteps and get all those degrees yourself?
Actually, he got into much different, fields than, what I want to do. Like, for me, I want to actually, get into, communications, broadcasting, get behind the mic and maybe, I've always been a sports guy, and one of my personal goals is, get behind the mic, be a broadcaster, call games, stuff like that.
Now, I know from your video, you were, one of the things you addressed was that Mickey would make fun of the sound of your voice. Are you concerned about that going into broadcasting?
The thing is, for years, I've always been, insecure about, how I sounded, because there were some people that gave me stuff like, oh, this guy sounded like Squidward if he sucked on helium and stuff like that. And I'm like, look, if you're not going to like my voice, then just go screw yourself and everything like that. Like, everyone sounds different.
That's right.
And, I've always hated when some people just mock my own voice, and I just, it only happens, maybe once or twice, and then I just give them, a little glare, and they stop.
Yeah, just give them that quick glance of hatred.
And if they want, if some boy wants to actually, keep it going on and on, then it's not going to be that surprising when I go up to him one day and, kick him in the nuts.
Right. That's the way to stop a bully, I think, is just one square kick in the nuts. Yeah, Hill.
Yeah, people say it's a cheap shot, but I say, it's a very easy way to get a bully. They're looking to crush your face and stuff like that, but I say, no. In order to, you don't need to punch him in the face. You don't need brass knuckles or anything like that. Just get him in the nuts. They'll be crying or, whimpering on the ground. And, they're not going to mess with you anymore.
Yeah, that's not a cheap shot at all. It's just the easiest way to
take
care of it.
It's just a smart move, especially if it's a guy that's going after you. Remember, the testicles are a very sensitive area. And
is that what you told the girls when they asked you about sex?
No. Let's not... Okay, let's stop talking about that, please.
Yeah, no, you're right. It was inappropriate.
If someone actually does get kicked right there, it's a very sensitive area. If he actually get kicked right there, not only would it lead to, let's say, a bruise, but I've actually heard that some people actually get kicked there, and, listen, stories that some people were actually kicked there so hard that they actually, started bleeding out, red urine. It was, really disgusting. I was like, oh, man.
I don't think that's urine at that point.
Yeah, that's just – you're bleeding blood right now. And you're urinating blood. I'm like, oh, God.
Right.
Yeah, so, no, I'm not going to do it, to the point where, their nuts are gone or anything like that. They can't make, babies or anything like that anymore.
How many times have you kicked a guy in the nuts?
So far, none. But, again, if
none? How do you know it's going to work if you've never done it?
Yeah, I know. I'm not a really violent person.
Oh, have you been in any actual physical fights with any of these bullies in your
Luckily,
life?
Luckily, no. I will say this. One time in sixth grade, I did actually have some jackass, pick me up and put me against the lockers, for some stupid reason. But aside from that, no fights or anything like that. No punches. I've been lucky to avoid those.
That's good. But you always have your secret weapon waiting in case it happens.
Yes, if somebody comes up to me and goes I'm going to break your face, and it's okay, all right, fine. I just broke your balls. See ya.
Yeah. Okay, let's chat. If you have any more questions for Baseball Sam before we both go to bed, not together, just separately, let us know in the chat.
Yeah, it's at 2:13 at this point. I think we've been talking for about less than an hour at this point.
Yeah, it's been an enlightening hour. I was really excited.
And
to...
also, here's the thing, Monkey, I got to actually thank you for something, because of this this Twitch stream you did. Before, I think I had around something 1980 something subscribers. But because of, when you show that video of me, you actually got me over 2,000, which was one of my personal goals that I wanted to get done by the end of season 4. And thanks to this stream, I got there, and I didn't expect it. And I just want to say thanks for that.
Oh, no, don't thank me. Thank all the people who subbed. I mean, I just showed the video. They're the ones who put in the effort to subscribe.
Yeah, thank them, too. I thank all of them.
Yeah, no, everybody. If you haven't subscribed to Baseball Sam yet, Carson Geek will post a link right now. You can go... subscribe. Do you Would you say that your content these days is similar to the Breaking the Fourth Wall video at all, or is it entirely different?
Actually, it still has the same basis, like, you know, review something, bring up points that I like or don't like. But yeah, it's not really, it's a bit different. It's like, you know, kind of like, it's not like, you know, over the top. It's not like, you know, angry and stuff like that. It's more just, you know, like really better focus on trying not to be so repetitive, trying to make the videos not too long, not too like, you know, like oversaturated and stuff like that. Just really just get to the point, make your like your little, like talk about your opinion. And if you want to make a joke, go ahead. Like if it has a point to it.
Right.
So
a natural flow.
Yes, like, you know, instead of just having, like, you know, go on and on about it.
Right, you don't want to, because Nostalgia Critic, he'll just go on and on with a shitty skit for 5 hours.
Yeah, like, again, in Nostalgia Critic's content, it's not really, like, you know, horrible. It's not really, like, something, like, you know, like, but I will say that his quality has sharply declined. Like, eventually got to a point where he was starting to review stuff like Boss Baby and Angry Birds. And, like, okay, I can understand if he doesn't really like them that much, but I never really understand why he really had to do it. And it was more just like, oh, the fans requested me to do it. It's like, you know, you don't always have to do stuff that fans request. You can still do stuff you want to do.
Yeah, especially when it's, like, a good movie like those.
Yeah, and he actually did do that. Like, he actually just recently, like, he's recently wrapping up his, like, X month. Like, he's talked about, like,
the X-Men first three movies, right?
Movies, X-Men 1, 2, and, of course, Last Stand, and now he's about to talk about X-Men Origins Wolverine.
Well, speaking of Nostalgia Critic, Lime Jingo wants to know what your thoughts are on the Channel Awesome situation.
Yeah, the thing is, with all that stuff happened with the report and stuff like that, I actually did make a couple references to, like, what the situation that was happening in some previous videos. But, yeah, the CEO of Channel Awesome, Mike Michaud, is a jackass. And Doug and Rob, like, you know, not actually talking about it at all and keeping it silent and stuff like that, that's pretty cowardly.
Right. Have you ever thought about starting your own Channel Awesome?
It definitely did hinder their reputations.
Right. Have you thought about starting your own Channel Awesome so that you can avoid the mistakes that Mike Michaud made?
No. Someone I knew tried, an ex-friend of mine tried that, and this ex-friend, and it did not pan out well.
Right. You and I were going to be in it, and then it all fell apart.
Because he decided he wanted to actually be so Channel Awesome that he was, like, going back on what he said, like, oh, this is not for the money. This is more just for fun and stuff like that. No, he wanted to turn it into an enterprise and, you know, like, get merchandise and stuff like that. I'm like, what the fuck are you doing?
Right.
And so he was like, all these, like fights and stuff like that with a couple of people that I knew. And so eventually he just disbanded, and then we were just done with him. And at this point, he's actually not really making any videos. Like, it's been, like, months since he made his last video.
Oh, so he's not like Doug Walker at all. He's not prolific online.
Yeah, like, the only thing, like, that's different about him really is, like, Canadian, the gap in his teeth, and the phony glasses, probably with no, you know, like lenses in it at all. The red and, like, the ginger hair, and that's kind of it. I mean, like, honestly, like, for people that are saying that I'm a ripoff and stuff like that, well, if you're thinking I'm a ripoff, check out this guy. Like, it's like, it fits him too. If you want to see a real NC ripoff, there you go.
All right,
like,
Sam.
I still, yes, I understand, like, influence, you dress pretty similar, you probably sound like him.
Right.
But again, those are just major coincidences.
If we can pivot. People are curious about your feelings on the new Star Wars movies. Have you been a fan of the new trilogy?
Actually, yeah. I mean, like, I know they're not really, like, you know, super duper great. I know I acknowledge they have flaws. I do. But I still do enjoy them. And actually, the thing is, the previous Star Wars movies, like, you know, the prequels and stuff like that, those came out when I was, like, around, like, the first one, Phantom Menace, that was 1 year before I was born. Attack of the Clones came out when I was around, like, maybe, like, one or two. And then Revenge of the Sith came out when I was just around, like, 4 or 5 years old. So they never really took me to the movie theaters to see that. And in fact, the first movie I ever saw in theaters was Pixar's Cars. Like, I remember seeing that in the theaters for the first time.
Was that 2006?
Yes.
Yeah.
Well, that was the first. Like, the thing is, like, they didn't really want to take me out anywhere because, of course, for all those, like, you know, parents that
Like, you go like, why don't you take your kids out anywhere? Well, have you seen them? Some of them actually start crying when they actually get everywhere. And, like, that was how my brothers were with, like, you know, when they were, like, two or three. They'd start crying. They'd start yelling. They would not shut up. And we could not take them out to any place. Even when we want to try to go to, like, some basic restaurant, they would just, like, become a big problem. And, like, for years, we couldn't go out to restaurants. But now they moved on from that, and thank God.
Yeah, you were so young. I mean, maybe your dad was scared that a college girl might try to sit next to you in the movie theater.
Yeah, sure.
Okay. Speaking of the new Star Wars movies, Baron Von... I'll go ahead.
The first Star Wars movie I watched in theaters for the very first time was Force Awakens.
Okay.
And the second one was, like, Rogue One. Actually, like, that was when I went to Disney, and they actually had, a nice little movie theater. It was, like, really nice, really, like, you know, bright and colorful. And it was a really nice movie theater. It was very clean. Like, it was probably one of the best movie theaters I've ever been to. And we watched Rogue One. And it was fun.
Well, this isn't about Rogue One, but more about the new trilogy. You're aware of the actress who plays Rey is Daisy Ridley. Do you like her?
Yeah. And I also just want to say, like, for anybody that actually starts giving her shit about, like, you know, like, feminist propaganda and, like, you suck and everything like that, why are you saying this to the actor? I mean, like, she really has nothing to do with it. All she's doing is just acting. Like, right. I really get the backlash around it. Like, it's just ridiculous and pathetic.
Well, Baron Von Brunk in the chat wants to know, Sam, what would you do if Daisy Ridley knocked on your door at 4 a.m. and told you she wants you? What would you do?
Okay, whether you're a famous celebrity or not, if anybody goes up to your door at 4 a.m. and says, I want you, that's when you say, yeah, no.
Even Daisy Ridley. Door.
No, like, okay, I like, again, that's a pretty ridiculous scenario, don't you think? I mean, like,
well, sure, it's hypothetical. We've all thought about it.
Joke and stuff like that, but honestly, like, no, not like, even if I was, like, at my most desperate point, if I actually was really desperate, I'd go, like, no, way too late at this point. No.
Okay. Now that you're 18, you're old enough to vote in your first election. Do you have any candidates that you're looking forward to voting for in 2020?
I don't give a shit about politics.
No, you're not going to go vote for Trump or Bernie Sanders or anybody for fun.
Here's the thing about politics for me. I've never like, you know, Republican or Democratic or Green Party or Libertarian or anything like that. I mean, I've gotten comments from my, like, you know, my parents go, like, you're pretty liberal and stuff like that. And I'm like, okay, you can believe what you want to believe. But, like, okay, if I had to pick a party, for me, I just say independent, because that's, like, you know, no party. You're not supporting any kind of candidate, Republican, Democratic, whatever. If I actually had to make my own party on my own, I'd say the Common Sense Party, because right now it seems like no politician has any common sense whatsoever, making, like, the most basic human mistakes over and over and over again, saying the absolute worst you could possibly imagine with absolutely no filters whatsoever, and thinking they could still get away with this shit just because they have high power. It does not work.
Sorry, are you officially announcing you're starting the Common Sense Party to speak truth to power? All the politicians are messed up.
It was more of a joke, really. Like, again, like I said before, I don't give a shit about politics.
Okay. So no Common Sense Party?
No.
No. Would you ever consider running for president when you're old enough?
No. 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 That's, I mean, for anybody, even for, like, someone like Trump right now, I acknowledge being a president is really difficult. Like, I honestly wouldn't really know what to do if I actually had to do something like, you know, foreign policy and, like, you know, tariffs and stuff like that. Like, I don't know. I probably would, presidency is not for me. There's some things I know that I know I'm not going to really be good at. Like, say, if someone said, you should probably be a nurse. No, I am not fit for that job.
No, you'd rather be a doctor.
A doctor? No, I'm not going to be a doctor.
Okay.
So, like, is there any other questions?
If you're ready to go to bed, we can just say goodbye here. I don't see any other questions right now.
Axe, maybe a couple more, and then I'll go to bed. I'm not really that tired.
Bacon Crafted Curtain wants to know what type of YouTube content do you usually watch?
Obviously it's reviewing too, but there's also, like, sports videos. Music, like, you know, once I got myself into high school, I started getting really into music. Like, I was starting to get into other groups like Pink Floyd,
the Beatles, Blue Oyster Cult, My Morning Jacket, all these kind of different bands, which apparently nobody in my school listens to because all they're concerned about is country and rap all the freaking time.
Nobody at your school listens to real music like the Beatles and all that?
Yeah. Okay, actually, here's the thing. I've seen a couple people go around with like Pink Floyd, Dark Side of the Moon on their shirt, and I've seen one person have an Iron Maiden shirt, which is another band I like. And okay, so it's not every person that likes country and rap, but for the most part, especially for the people on my baseball team, they'll be shouting out Sweet Caroline, any other rap song that's like, you know, popular for the time, like, you know, all those like trendy stuff.
Have you ever suggested to them like maybe you were born in like the wrong generation and that they should appreciate the older music?
That's actually something my parents have told me. It's like, you're like an old soul in a young kid's body.
That's right.
Yes. Like, and again, I actually, my opinion on Snapchat is pretty much like what an old person would be for any piece, like for any social media platform. Like, these people just are more concerned with their Snapchat and stuff like that. I honestly believe I sound like a 55-year-old man when I say that.
You don't use Snapchat.
I mean, I have a Snapchat. The only reason I actually have it is because like I'm in a couple groups. Like, one is the baseball team Snapchat group. And another one that's actually a drama club. I actually go to drama club in my school, but I don't really participate in a lot of meetings now because, well, I got baseball on the side.
So is this like a fan Snapchat? Like, can fans of Baseball Sam 1 add you? And
No.
It's none of that.
Like, again, I did do a Discord one time, but it didn't really go anywhere, and I ended up like, I just recently stopped using the Discord.
Oh, you don't like interacting with your fans. You think they're
No, it's just more like I never really, like, you know, participated that much. Never really had time to do Discord, and sometimes I kind of would forget. And it didn't really make any sense to, like, you know, have it there when I'm not really there all the time. So
right, yeah, no, that's fair. So you deleted it and said goodbye, fans, forever.
No, not really. I'm still on Discord. I still talk to a couple of people on Discord. It's just like I don't really participate in these kind of like servers all the time. Like, I'm in a few. Like, I'm actually in the Alpha J Show. Discord is another cartoon reviewer, but I don't really, like, go there all the time and stuff like that. Hmm. Just, like, you know, maybe I'll go there maybe like once or twice, but it's not really like my main concern.
So where should these new Baseball Sam fans, where should they go to interact with you on social media? Do you have a Twitter they could follow?
Yes. It's at SDYankee17. It's all caps. And again, if you want to check out my channel itself, it's Baseball Sam 1. If you want to check it out, go ahead. Again, I'm not really, like, the thing is about me, like, the people in my school know that I do these channels and, like, I do these videos, but I don't go around going like, hey, check out this video I made. Like, I'm not a big advertiser. And even then, there's a part of me that's just kind of like, you know, kind of embarrassed when someone else goes like and watch my stuff and like just go like, man, this kid is silly. What's he doing? And it's like,
what is there to be embarrassed about, though? Like, you're just making videos.
Yeah, I know. I really shouldn't be embarrassed about that. I know they probably like this, like the stuff. And I'm glad they're actually watching it. But again, it's just like that part of me that's just, you know, kind of like, like, again, I'm not really like all like attention hungry, something like that. You know?
Yeah, that's true. You do it for like, the art, more, not for the
like,
fame.
Like, I don't really have much of an ego, really.
No, I don't think so. Yeah, I think you're an artist at heart, and you're not in it for the fame and fortune.
Yeah, I never go for the money. I never even started off with the money. I never actually turned on monetization. I never have earned any money.
You never turned on monetization?
Never have.
Why not?
I just never did it for the money. I just wanted to do it just because, well, to entertain people, let people know what I thought of certain things, and just, I don't know.
I mean, it's,
I just wanted to try it, and like once I started doing it, like the first review, I actually remember the first review I ever did, January 22nd, 2016, and right now it's March 24th, 2019, and yeah, it's been over 3 years.
It's 3 years of doing it for free.
Yep.
You're like a 4chan janitor.
What? It's 4chan janitor?
Yeah, they do it for free.
I've never heard of that, thank you for telling me.
Finally, somebody wants to know your thoughts on the New Zealand mosque attack. I don't know what this is. Do you know what this is?
Some sort of shooting happened in New Zealand. Now they're adding like new rules, like you can't have these kind of weapons anymore, like banning them and stuff.
What the hell happened?
What
happened?
I honestly don't know. Again, I've never really like been someone who like, you know, goes and reads these kind of stories. I'm more into like, you know, like reading about sports and stuff like that. Again,
right.
This like the shooting, it really is sad. I really feel bad for like
it was sad.
That lost their like members and everything like that.
The shooting was sad?
Yeah, it really was. Like, it really shouldn't happen, but of course it happened. It was like some sort of like someone who like the media is making it seem like, oh, video games was the reason, like this kid, like he was mocked, he was bullied, and it was like, no, do not try to make this person sympathetic. He still went out there and did such a horrible, heinous crime. No.
Right.
There's really no sympathy you can give them.
Yeah, I hate it when the media tries to make us sympathize with these, like, killers and stuff.
And also, I hate it when the media goes, like, it blame the video games for making all of us violent. No, it's our reaction to the video games that makes us violent, not the video games themselves. That's why there's always these pointless lawsuits against people like, you know, Rockstar Games. Like, they've been sued multiple times by multiple people because they're like, just like, you know, they affected their people in so many ways, causing them to be violent and stuff like that. And it's like, no, how about you be better parents to your kids rather than like, you know, letting them like, you know, have full reign on watching and playing these games. If they can't handle it, then take it away. Okay,
right. So potentially, if the parents don't intervene, the video games could make somebody violent if they can't handle it.
Like, again, this really just comes down to parenting. Like, someone really right. just be parents to your children. Like, really, like, okay, it's fine to give them a few video games, but if they're clearly getting influenced in a really bad way, let's say they start swearing, like, right out of nowhere and start being violent with other people and stuff like that, and if it's really being attributed to video games, then put a stop to it. Do not just, like, blindly, like, oh, like, again... Like, again, it's not
Did the New Zealand shooter say he did it because of video games?
I don't know. I think it was like a couple of stories saying like he was bullied, mocked for this.
He was mocked for being bad at video games.
Again, these were like stories I saw passing by. I never really like read the entire thing. It was just like, it was basically just read for a few seconds, and it was just like, really, they're trying to make this shooter, this killer, the person that killed lots of people, sympathetic. And it was like, no,
ew,
and
I
just moved on.
Yeah, that's horrible.
That's a really just screwed up situation. Like, don't be making these guys sympathetic. Actually, just be saying, like, I don't really know. Like, it's the New Zealand shooting, it's really, like, a really horrible thing. And, like,
it's really horrible.
Like, for any other shooting, for any other place, that's always horrible when a shooting happens.
What do you think the punishment should be for the shooter?
If he actually didn't kill himself in the act, lots and lots of jail
time. Yeah, like if he got arrested, what should they do with him?
Lots and lots of jail time.
How much? How many years? Like 50?
Okay, I'm not going to say it's like for life or anything like that, but, you know, for years, long time. I don't know. Again, I'm not
like 1 year for every person he killed?
Huh?
Like maybe like 1 year for each person he killed?
Honestly, I don't know. Again, I'm not like a judge or anything like that. I can't really make those decisions. Right. But like, again, anybody can make their own decision. I bet there probably might be somebody go like, oh, send this guy to jail for life. He's a menace and all that kind of stuff. Again, I really don't like talking about subjects like this.
Yeah, right.
It just like, makes me feel miserable.
Life in jail, like that seems like a pretty harsh punishment.
If it actually happens to someone who's like clearly insane and is not going to learn his lesson or anything like that, then yeah, give him a life sentence.
Mm. Maybe he can be rehabilitated and, you know, still contribute to society.
Some can be, like, let's say robbers or muggers or anything like that. Obviously, it stems from, like, let's say their house is getting foreclosed on. They're desperate for money and stuff like that. Some people could probably be some could go through rehab. And actually, there's some people that do come back from jail, and they actually become much better human beings. So, yeah. So there's always hope for somebody.
Yeah, maybe one day he'll be, you know, he'll return to a mosque and, like, apologize and, like, maybe he'll get a job there and clean up, like, sweep up.
That's, I honestly don't know. Again, like, yeah. That probably would be a big miracle if that really did happen. Like some things like that we wish could really happen, like, on a daily basis, but obviously in reality it doesn't always happen.
Right.
But it does feel good when there actually is somebody that actually has done some bad things. And they finally acknowledged, yes, they did do bad things, and I'm ashamed of that, and I want to, like, you know, be better from that. That's really, like, what I really want to hear. Like, some actually trying to improve from their past mistakes.
Right, yeah. I think we should always give people a second chance when they make a mistake.
And if they end up blowing that second chance, then they're not going to prove themselves for anybody. They're actually not going to change for anybody. They're just going to be the same person over and over and over again and not care. Then why should we care?
Yeah, like if they let him out and he goes and shoots up another mosque, then we should definitely give him a life sentence.
Yeah, because if he didn't learn his lesson the first time, he's going to really learn his lesson again.
Right. Yeah. Like one strike, two strikes, you're out. There's no three strikes here.
In baseball, it's the three strikes and you're out. But we're not going to baseball, rules in real life.
No, sometimes, yeah. When it comes to shooting up a mosque, it's two strikes and you're out.
Yep.
Yeah,
I guess
fair.
So. I don't know.
I think it's fair.
Okay.
Well, I don't know. I mean, I guess we could leave it there on that happy note. I don't really have any other questions for you.
Yeah. It's 2:34 right now. It's been like a really long night.
Well, I'll tell you this. A week from today, I'm doing a 24-hour stream, and I need lots of content. So maybe you can, if you're bored next Saturday, you can hop on and we can hang out and maybe do some fun stuff.
I'll think about it. Sure. We'll see what happens.
We don't
like,
have to go bowling.
Yeah. Okay. I'll think about it. I'll see what I can do. The schedule I have for baseball, it's also pretty sporadic. We do have weekend games. So
sense.
The thing is, I was actually supposed to go to a Carolina Hurricanes hockey game, which is against their rival. It's March 28th, but I can't do that because got a baseball game.
Right.
So, yeah, and now, my dad's going to take my two brothers to come along. It was going to be me, my dad, and my brother Nick that was going to go and see it. Both my dad and my brother, they're Caps fans. Screw that.
Yeah.
But, yeah, okay, but the thing was, that was the original plan, but because I have the baseball game, now it's going to be, dad, Nick, and my other brother Joseph that's going to go. And they actually have front row. They're actually going to be right on the glass watching the action. I'm like, damn it.
Ah, you're missing out.
Yeah, I know. But again, I can't just skip a game. That's pretty inexcusable.
Right, yeah. Okay, well.
You have these tickets and you go to, the big, gigantic concert when actually you should be going to, this big, gigantic, interview that could probably give you a good, lucrative job. But
right.
You said, fuck it, I'm gonna go get myself smashed. It's like, no one should try that.
Yeah, no, I think you're absolutely right. I hope you do well at your game next week, though. Maybe you can tell Carson the score, and I can report. Baseball Sam wins game, baseball game, 7-1.
Yeah, I wish maybe that could happen if I actually did get a chance to pitch. So we'll see what happens.
All right, Sam, I'll let you go. It's 2:36 in the morning. Thank you for coming on and spilling your guts about your great YouTube career so far.
Yeah. Okay. Thank you so much.
Yeah. I'll talk to you later, bud.
All right. See ya.
Well, folks, there you have it. The one and only Baseball Sam, the creator of my favorite YouTube video. Rejected me yet again.
Monkey, I'm outside right now. Can I pet your cat before you go?
Oh, God. Uh-oh.